Okay, I'm going to try to make this quick, but it was a little bit longer than what my phone will allow. So, and if I use my other phone, that gives me a few more minutes. It's really poor quality. So, in the description box below, I will be posting, I'm going to find one, the one to Clifford Carnicom, or however you say it. Anyway, Clifford Carnicom, I think, he has a website. I'm going to have to get on my computer. Maybe I can find it on my phone, actually. And I'll send those to my email so I have them all ready to go. And I'll just copy-paste in the description box below. But I haven't gone to his yet. But one that I'm currently watching right now, it's about a little bit over an hour. And she starts off by talking about this chronic fatigue syndrome, and I believe she said 1980, they basically infected a bunch of mosquitoes. What they do is they, according to one of the other videos that I watched that goes into the science of it, I will also post that link in the description box below. It's pretty scientific, but it's about hair growth and the whole system, the hair shaft, the hair follicle, and how the stem cells contained in there, and how they get all these different little creatures that carry these gene changing it's very scientific, so I'm not remembering all the words. It's transgenic, okay? They're trying to transfer genes from these little tiny things that can get into your hair follicle, in your skin, etc., etc. And trying to change our DNA that way, okay? Oh, tricky little demons, aren't they? Oh, gosh. But they're still not smarter than God. And anyway, I'm not going to go off on a big old spiritual tangent. I want to stick to the nuts and bolts of this. So she's talking about in 1980 they injected, I believe how they do it is I don't know if she explains, I kind of put that on pause because I had to get this out, but the other one that's talking about the hair follicle stuff, because I've had a lot of issue with my hair, and I'll get into that in a second with all the hair stuff, but they inject the ovaries of these different, like wasps, mosquitoes, the ants, different things, that carry this gene, okay? So they did this with mosquitoes, and, released them, I believe she said, in Florida. And then within a short amount of time, a lot of people were complaining of how, this onset of chronic fatigue syndrome. And she gives the actual scientific name of it, but you know, the government and all the doctors here have been told to call it chronic fatigue syndrome to kind of dumb it down so no one's alerted enough to go do this research. And so you can see what they're doing, okay? They're doing it with chemtrails. It's not just the heavy metals in the chemtrails. There's all kinds of stuff. They're trying to change your DNA. This transhumanist thing. I know it sounds out of this world, and I've always been a skeptic, and I don't even watch TV. My mom was a Trekkie. I hated that crap. I couldn't even stand it for a minute. It was like soap operas to me. I'm like, oh my God, get me out of this room. I can't stand science fiction. I've never read science fiction. I don't care for any of that kind of stuff. Excuse me, so for me to be talking about this, I'm just like, but according to all this research that I've been doing, this stuff is real, okay? This silent government, the dark guiding hand that's actually behind the scenes running this fake puppet government that you're voting for, Hillary, Trump, blah, 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 blah. They're not the ones in charge of anything, okay? They're just the front man, the front runner. It's the evil, dark, guiding hand behind it of these, you know, the oligarchy, the few elite evil that are running everything. And it's bigger than big business, Rothschild, but I mean, these people are evil. They're not human, okay? So all these things, all these dots are being connected as I look back. Years ago, gosh, it must have been... So I broke up, I was with someone for 9 years, and we broke up when I was 32, I'm gonna say. So about 8 years ago, I'm gonna be 41 next month in January. So 8, 9, 10 years ago about, yeah, because when we moved out of that apartment in Petaluma, 3 Indigo Drive, at Azure Lakeville Square, so Azure and 3 and Indigo, okay, so those little synchronicities, it was like starting then. I remember I was getting these weird, and I was going through a lot of like weird emotional stuff and throwing up a lot, but I've always had anxiety attacks since 8 years old. I remember the first one I had, so I thought, oh, it just has to do with that and whatever, bad, you know, ending to a relationship that wasn't too bad, but just going through that bad ending phase. And the year prior, I had just lost my sister. She died on her birthday, overdosed, shooting meth, she was prostituting, all this stuff. So I just thought I was just, you know, having some emotional issues and going through a lot of stuff. So I thought, but I knew I wasn't crazy, because I'm very intelligent, well-balanced, extremely skeptical. But this thing I started noticing with my hair, and I was like, why is my hair changing at 32? I'm starting to get my dad's hair, because he has black wavy hair. But these hairs weren't wavy. And I have very fine, like strawberry, like brown, like reddish brown hair. And these hairs were very different. And I noticed they were like sticking straight out, like on the back, like little alfalfa sprout back in the back there, and then like on the sides. And I was pulling them out, and they were thick, dark, like black, thick, straight hairs, and they wouldn't lay down flat, like nice and smooth like my other hairs. And then around the side in front, around my forehead, I just remember like they were itchy. And I had to pull them all out. And I remember it would bleed a little bit, a couple of them. And I thought, oh, God, I don't have, like, this hair-pulling weird, like, psychological problem. Do I? I started looking that up. I'm like, it's just subconsciously my body was saying, pull these hairs out, pull these hairs out, pull these hairs out. And I would look in the sink after, and there would be just all these little short, dark, black, very rigid hairs. And I remember pulling them out, they didn't have a follicle at the end, and I thought that was weird, because it usually has that little clear little bulb, which is, you know, the little, when you pull a hair out, or a hair falls out, when you're brushing your hair or whatever, it always has that little white, little clear ball at the end, okay? And it didn't have that. And I remember how, like, deeply rooted it was in the hair, and it didn't have that, and it was so thick, like, I could almost hear it when I was pulling them out. And I was kind of embarrassed a little bit, because I had, like, these little bald spots on the side, but I was just like, oh, God, get these hairs out. And I remember having a dream that later, when I saw that movie, The Black Swan, I was like, that's so weird, because I had a dream that was kind of similar to when she started getting, like, those black feathers coming out of her shoulder or something on her back, you know. And I thought to myself, that's like the dream that I had, that these, it wasn't like a feather, it was like a feather without the feathery part, just like the needle part. It just seemed like a really thick black dark hair, and long and straight and thick and rigid like a feather, but just the shaft part of it, not the fluffy, feathery part, okay? So, with all the thing that, all the stuff that, Morgellons, all the hair stuff that it's associated with, It ties itself in knots. I was noticing that too. I'm like, how does a hair get tied in a knot on its own? I remember having, like, there would be a little ball on the hair, but it was a knot. And I kept noticing that too. And I thought, okay, well, I have long hair, I guess it could, but I don't know how a single hair could tie itself in a knot. And I kept noticing it was several times, not just once or twice. And so that's another thing I just came across in my research, was that it ties itself in knots. It kind of is thicker and more scratch. It was just not my normal hair. It was doing weird things, like tying itself in a knot. And then those black hairs, like I was saying. And so it makes your hair fall out. And I noticed a couple years ago when I was living with my dad in New Mexico, it was falling all out around the same part where I had pulled those little black hairs out. My normal hair had grown back, but then it started falling out there again. And now, but gray, thick gray hair grew in its place. And I thought, oh, well, it's just normal aging or whatever. And some of that could have been, yes, but it's just odd that my hair, the little tiny fine baby hairs that don't get any longer, they always stay the same length, those were starting to fall out, and they were like all in the sink, you know. So, and another more recent, so that was, you know, a couple years ago, and then all the way back to when I was like 32, with the little black hairs and the little knots and different things changing with my hair. And then recently, since I've had this channel, okay, I posted some synchronicities about hominid, evonid. I was watching, not the craft, Practical Magic, yes, with Sandra Bullock and Nicole Kidman. And it's from Denovi Productions, or the film company, or whatever. But backwards, it spells Evonid. Evo is the name of my twin flame. And Nid means nest, because I was watching another movie in the same grouping of movies. You can check out 10 at the library. It was in the same grouping of movies, okay, where Jack Black, and I did a little video on that synchronicity too. Jack Black is in this psych ward. He, you know, the police bring him in or whatever, but they take him to the hospital because he's, you know, supposedly crazy. Okay, but he shows this picture and depicts this story of the, you know, these angels, dark forces, whatever. But he tells the doctor, "I'm just a nid." So it already looked up nid, because evo nid, and then hominid, okay, human nest, and then he said, "I'm just a nid, I'm just a nest." So all this nest stuff was coming to me. And hominid, that's interesting. I'm gonna have to research when we when that word was invented and when we started using that word, because that might coincide with when they decided to start doing this. And one of my tarot decks, the Mother Earth deck, I believe it's the Five of Swords, I don't know, it's the Five of something, and the Wasp is on there, okay? And I looked up Wasp medicine, and they have the longest ovipositor, okay? And that's, and they can sting over and over and over again, and they don't lose that. So they can, what they can do is inject their eggs into a host like a caterpillar, and something else, I think, so the hosts won't reject it or whatever, but so they can lay their eggs in, you know, an old piece of rotting wood, anything that would sustain the eggs and let them come to their full larval and, you know, and then come out of the caterpillar or the piece of rotted wood or whatever. And then this box that I have says something in Latin and has a rose and a bee on there, and the translation from Latin is the bee gives the rose honey. Is that what it is? The bee gives the rose honey. I think that's what it is. Anyway, so, and that's all about, like, the hive, worker bee, hive mentality. That's the whole thing behind this transhumanism. That's the whole idea, okay, to have a bunch of worker bees and that live forever, that don't reproduce, that, okay, all this stuff. And the queen wasp decides who gets to be male, who gets to be female, and which females get to reproduce. Okay? So, the most recent shamanic dream that I had about, the, pheasant crow, I didn't know there was an actual bird called the pheasant crow, but God just showed me in my dream, because I wouldn't have known what the pheasant crow was if he just showed me a pheasant crow. I say he, but okay, whatever, pronouns. So it was a big, giant, black crow that specifically flew up on the edge of this overpass, like walk the bridge over this creek, to show me its back. And I was like, that's odd, it has like butterfly kind of markings, like symmetrical and very colorful. I'm like, but in my dream I'm like, well, it's gotta be a type of pheasant though, but it looked like a crow, because pheasants are the only birds that I could think of that are like around here or whatever. I don't think I've ever seen one in real life, but I you know, I've seen their feathers, I've seen pictures of them, they're very colorful, and it's kind of like a bird version of a butterfly, sort of. So that's the only way God could depict that, so that I could understand pheasant crow, because it was in one bird, okay? And pheasants are very much about sexuality, reproduction, and concealment. And crows are the ancient way, okay? Big, especially if they're very large, it represents the most ancient version of that. And so, and birds, just that ancient wisdom, that's the main thing about bird totems, is they're like descendants of the dinosaurs and stuff, so they are maintaining that ancient wisdom, okay, is locked inside them. And so I'm looking up pheasant crow the other day, I think the day before Christmas Eve, so a couple days ago, and I got off the shamanic site, because I'm like, I just felt called to go look up the actual bird on a, because I wasn't finding pheasant crow, I was finding pheasant and crow, but not necessarily pheasant crow on the shamanic sites, and I'm like, there's a pheasant crow, okay, because I googled it, and so I'm like, nixed the shamanic sites and went to just an actual scientific publication of, you know, someone who just studies birds and aviary and whatever. And it's very rare. It's in the cuckoo bird family, which I think the cuckoo bird's unless that's the dodo bird. Anyway, I thought the cuckoo bird was extinct. But it's out of all these different, you know, like 50 some are this kind of, and four species of the cuckoo bird, one including the pheasant crow, are non-parasitic birds, and that's very key. A non-parasitic bird does not lay its eggs in the nest of another bird. Okay, it makes its own nest and lays its own eggs in its own nest. It doesn't use an old nest from another bird or share a nest with another bird. And okay, so non-parasitic, meaning it does not lay its eggs in the nest of any other bird. It has its own nest. So this is linking up with the nid, the hominid, the evonid, all these nid nests, okay, that came to me. And nits, okay, head lice was coming to me too, because someone that I have synchronicities with, and then my child last year, his first year of preschool, he got a notification about, oh, possible exposure to head lice, and I had gotten that several times when I was a child in school. They like straight hair shafts and very clean hair, and I had very straight hair and was a very clean kid, so always had my hair washed and clean because the eggs can stick to it really well. And those are called nits, okay? The eggs are called nits, and the lice are, the individual one is called a louse. And more is called, it's just like mouse, mice, louse, lice. And the eggs are called nits. So nits, nids, hominid. The pheasant crow is non-parasitic. Okay, so all these, God has been trying to tell me this for, since ever, when I had that dream with that weird hair growing out, and then I actually had those hairs in real life that I was pulling out, and I was looking up that hair pulling disease. I'm like, no, this is not me. Like, I'm not, my body, my higher self is telling me to pull this stuff out. Okay, it was not normal. It was weird. But then I didn't, you know, as I saw him, I would pull him out, and then I didn't see him anymore, and I don't see him anymore now, but now they're like thick gray hairs. But when I took that baking soda bath, I noticed, I'm like, wow, it seems like there's less of those hairs, less little gray ones on the side there. So anyway, I'm kind of taking a break from my channel, but as I'm connecting a lot of dots, I'll be posting a video and then putting some very important links below. So the one that I'm currently watching is a little bit over an hour. I think it's only like an hour and 10 minutes or an hour and 1 minute. I don't know. Little, just slightly over an hour. So it's hour long one will be the first one. It's a woman with short black hair. You'll see her in the beginning, and then she goes off into her whole spiel. So, that's a little bit more digestible, if you will. The next link will be the one that's specifically about the injection of these things, whatever the government wants to use to get to us. They inject into the ovaries of different insects, and it goes into that hair follicle, and it's pretty scientific, okay, but it gives you kind of a general overview of just the, specifically the hair aspect of Morgellons, okay, and the association with the insect. And I believe this is also why a lot of insect totems have been coming to me. I had an issue with ants. Jehovah's Witness brought me this pamphlet, and they're talking about, well, look at the ant. It has to be intelligent design, because da-da-da-da. And I was having a problem with ants, and they were biting me when I was, because I have my futon mattress on the floor. I don't have a, you know, propped up off the, and we got sprayed and everything. And, but I've seen a stray one here or there. And when I do, I just squish them, because those little guys will bite you. So, but I already had this before that, so I'm not getting it from the little ant bites. And that only, you know, there was only like two or three little times where I got, but there, you know, you get bit by an ant, if you've ever been bit by an ant, it's a little zinger, you know. But I had this well before then. So I don't know, way back in the beginning, it could possibly have been a mosquito. I've had lots of mosquito bites in my life. I wasn't aware of chemtrails. I know they've actually been doing this for a long time, but I wasn't aware of chemtrails until about, probably just a couple years ago, actually, out when I was out in New Mexico at my dad's. He does a lot of research. He's very intelligent. He knows history. He knows theology, and he kept telling me about Morgellons and Sophia Smallstorm and Clifford Carnicon, and he's had, you know, he's seen UFOs. He knows a lot about a lot of stuff, and But I'm just like, oh, that's crazy. I don't want to hear about it. Blah, 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 blah. You know, skeptical. And I'm like, yeah, aliens. Yeah, right. Sure. Uh-huh. Yeah. And, but since I moved to where I live now, oh my gosh, the chemtrail thing is undeniable. And then, like I said, the filament stuff, I didn't have my phone, because I don't take my phone out in my backyard when I'm playing with my son and just enjoying the sunshine and stuff. But I'm going to start doing that. Wherever I go, I'm going to bring my phone with me, and I just don't know if it'll pick it up, because it's not that high of a quality. But I want to get a very good, high-quality camera so I can document this stuff. But as far as right now, I'm doing a lot of research on healing through natural things, magnets, scalar waves, that's all Tesla stuff, and the 369 has to do with the flower of life. The angles in the flower of life are 30, 60, and 90, and anything between that is like an interference, non-sustainable thing, okay? It's in between the angles. So the 369's been with me for years before I even knew of any of this stuff. I just like 369 for some reason, and on a calculator and stuff, it's like right in line, 369, okay? Right, all on the right side down the line. Like when you put in your PIN code or on a calculator or anything like that, the little square grid, 369 is right down along the right side there. But it has an implication with Tesla, but the flower of life, okay? And I just realized that when I was watching something else by Harold Kutzvella. He was talking about Morgellons and chemtrails and different things. So I was like, okay, this 369 is coming. All these dots are connecting. But what I'm focusing on is the history of it, which the first link in the description box will give you a good overview of how this is all coming together, how it started, how it's all coming to pass, how it's developing, where it all came from, okay? Well, it all came from the devil. I mean, it's all from Satan, you know. He's the only enemy, okay? People who are absorbed in the Matrix and watch TV and all this stuff and Black Lives Matter and feminism and all these different things, trying to pit women against men, trying to pit blacks against whites and whites against blacks, men against women, women against men, nations against other nations. Okay, it's a lie. The only enemy we have is Satan. And I don't call him Lucifer because that's his God-given name. And he was stripped of that title when he had his wings chopped off and he was cast down to earth, okay? So, only people who worship him as their god call him Lucifer. He is not of the light no longer. That was his God-given title. It's like when you get divorced, it's like, no, you don't get my name, bitch. You can go back to your maiden name, like that kind of, you know what I'm saying? So, he's the devil. He's Satan. He's the Lord of the Darkness, okay, which is no Lord at all, okay. But they're tricky, crafty little manipulators. You see how you see it in the news, you see it in disease, okay. He's got his little grubby little hands in all different little pots, okay. He's like an entrepreneur of darkness, okay. So I'm gonna get back to my research. I'm gonna finish watching this. The seminar, this lady's just a few minutes into it, I'm like, oh, I can sink my teeth into this. This is, and I like just not having to read stuff all the time, so like you can just lay back and listen to it, put your headphones on, you know, give yourself an hour. You know, if you're suffering from stuff and the doctors are giving you medicine that's not working, they're not telling you what it is, or they're telling you it's psoriatic arthritis, because you've been tested for everything, and just through process of elimination, they say, oh, well, it must be psoriatic arthritis, because there's no actual test for that disease. And I've tested negative multiple times. They've tested me for everything. HIV and AIDS, Epstein-Barr, All the different STDs, RA, which is rheumatoid arthritis, that has a marker, so it's it has an indicator if you have that or not. All my so-called, you know, all my white cell blood count, blah, 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 everything's in normal range. I'm perfectly healthy, right? Yeah, right, but all this stuff's happening to my body, and these medications aren't working, and so I'm just happy that I finally know what's going on.